Look at the neck. How steady can you keep the neck? Because at the moment, he's not quite tracking up enough in the trot. But I know if you get him a little bit longer and a little bit more forward, then he's going to track up in the trot more. A little bit longer in the neck and a little bit more forward. You will get him longer in the neck if you ride him more forward into something a little bit more secure on the rein. Then he tracks up more. This is better. Not less than this in the trot. Now, you said he was a little bit hotter today. I want to see you do something with this energy. Show me. Not lengthened trot, but a bigger trot. A bigger trot. A bigger trot. I really mean a bigger trot. Thank you. Good. There we go. That's nice. But now I want him a little bit more connected on the bridle, not fluffy on the reins. It's about you having your arms completely independent from the rest of your body. Your upper body's rising up and down, but your arms have to be reading what's going on with the front end and feeling and adjusting and reacting to him. If he's reaching for the bit, you follow a little bit. If he wants to come up a little bit, you create a little bit tension, but you are constantly feeling what's going on in the mouth. I don't want you ever not focused. I don't want you ever not reading your horse. You have to always feel what's happening underneath you as a good dressage rider and be constantly reacting to your horse. Because in dressage, you are constantly testing and constantly rewarding. That's what it is. Every second, you're always asking a question and getting an answer, and getting an answer requires you rewarding the horse. So it's not just about keeping your hand steady, it's about keeping your hand steady with feeling. Now ride a 15-meter circle. You find it, you have him never ready to turn right. You have to always have him ready to turn right. That's why you can't control the hind legs, because you never quite have him ready to turn right, because that wasn't 15 meters. Now do 15 meters. I want him ready to turn right, and that means that he's turning off your left rein with your right shoulder back. Keep turning him off your left rein and pushing him off your right leg. Turning him off your left rein, there you go. You feel it, huh? Yeah. It's about your left rein and your right leg. There you go. Good. That left hand has to go down towards your kneecap. We talked about that in the serpentines. It's being highlighted in the canter. Now you go large, and when you feel like he starts to get crooked, then you turn him off your left rein and your right leg. Hey, there you go. There you got him aligned on that long side. This is getting better, huh? Good job. That's it. I like the direction of pressure that you have with your left rein. Okay, turn him again because he gets a bit crooked. The moment just before you turn him is the moment when you get him straighter, yeah? So always have him ready to turn. Always.